Hello friends, welcome to Cropway's YouTube channel. Are you interested in growing your own mushrooms at home? You have come to the right place. Paddystraw mushrooms are an excellent option for beginners because they are easy to cultivate and have a delicious taste. In this video, we will show you step by step how to grow paddystraw mushrooms. Before we begin, here are the materials you will need: straw bundle, 15 to 20 bundles of straw or 15 kg, as per thickness of bundle, mushroom spawn, seed, 250 gram nutrition, 250 grams of Bengal gram or red gram bed size, 2 feet by 2 feet or 1.5 feet by 1.5 feet space, 3 feet by 3 feet or 2.5 feet by 2.5 feet, 7 to 10 square feet, bed. Start by removing the leaves of the straw bundle and cut to 2 feet size with a straw cutter. The required number of straw bundles are soaked in a tank of clean water for 12 to 16 hours. At the time of soaking, use 100 milliliters of formalin and 10 grams of bovistin per 100 liters of water. Where electric heaters are available, hot water should be used for treating the straw bundles. Remove the straw bundles from water and keep in standing positions for 5 to 6 hours so as to drain out the excess water from the outside and inside the straw bundles, and only 75% moisture will remain in the straw bundles. Spawn of 2 to 3 weeks should be used. Divide the spawn to 4 equal parts and make small pieces of spawn having size of thumb finger. Use 250 grams of dal powder grinded from whole grain of Bengal gram. Else use paddy husk or rice bran to reduce the cost of cultivation. It should also be divided to 4 equal parts. After arranging straw, spawn and nutrition, prepare the beds. First put a layer of straw of 6 inches height. See that the bases of straw are towards outer side and top portion are inside. Let the direction of the first layer be east-west or north-south. Take one part of the spawn out of the 4 parts and put the spawn pieces on the bed, leaving 2 inches from outer side and at 3 inches distance. Sprinkle the dal powder of Bengal gram or red gram over the spawn blocks and nearby area. Over the first layer, put again 6 inches height of straw. Arrange the straw on the opposite direction of the first layer, east-west of north-south. Take of another part of spawn and put the spawn piece at a distance of 3 to 4 inches as in the first layer. Also sprinkle the dal powder over it as done previously. Put the third layer of 6 inches of straw in parallel direction to the first layer and put rest 2 parts of spawn all over the third layer and sprinkle 2 parts of dal powder too. Cover the third layer with the final fourth layer of straw of 1 to 2 inches width, parallel to the second layer. Now press the layer at the top so that the mycelium can grow well. Cut the spilled straw all around the bed with the help of a scissors. After the bed is ready, cover it with white polythene or stitched sheet of cement, fertilizer bags. First 4 to 5 days keep the beds as such. After 4 to 5 days, the polythene sheet may be removed for 30 minutes daily for aeration and spray water only on portion of bed where straw is dried. After 10 to 11 days, when mycelium growth is observed, the polythene cover may be removed, exposing the bed to open air. Harvesting. First flush of mushroom comes out after 13 to 15 days of sowing. The mushroom should be harvested at bud stage, whose demand is more in the market and also tasty on cooking. After 14 to 15 days, first phase of harvesting is done, giving 90% of the yield. The beds may be retained for another after 5 to 10 days for the second phase of harvest of 10%, or can be taken outside for second phase harvest so that fresh bed can be laid out to save time of harvest cycle. Congratulations! You have successfully grown your own paddystraw mushrooms. These versatile mushrooms can be used in a variety of dishes and are sure to impress your friends and family. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe with your friends. See you next time. Happy cultivating!